possible unintended consequences of what I call an antiquated British education system was I got to read Shakespeare. Hamlet says, "What a piece of work is man! How noble in reason, how infinite in faculty! In action, how like an angel, in apprehension, how like a god! The paragon of animals! We are special, but we are merely matter. We are animals, but we behave like gods." The context of what Hamlet was saying, he's talking about how man can be good and bad and the human condition in general. But what he alludes to is something quite special. He alludes to the fact that human beings are unique. You know? So what is it that actually makes human beings unique? I think there are many answers to that question. And every one of those questions and answers have merit. But one truly unique ability that human beings have is the ability to tell stories. Yuval Harari, one of the most well-read authors today, thinker, and probably the only thinker who actually could find a positive spin on gossip, says the ability to speak about fiction is probably what separated us from other creatures. By gossiping, Homo sapiens managed to form groups, groups of up to 150 people, thereby beating the Neanderthals. By inventing ideas like money, religion, corporations, we became able to cooperate at a larger and larger scale, and that finally is what led to Homo sapiens ruling the world. People become united and powerful by believing in the same story. So then the question begets, what is a story? A story is a powerful tool, a tool to bring people together. Stories create a framework which help us to create our own individualities. Reality, it's nothing if not a story that came out of someone's imagination. The ability to imagine and then create a narrative is to me the defining difference between human beings and every other species that inherits this earth. Scientists have been experimenting with animals for a long time, decades long, and they've always tried to see whether animals have an imagination. We did a lot of experiments with chimpanzees, with bonobos, with other animals, and finally realized that there are a few that can pretend. And what does pretending mean? Pretending means to be able to use your imagination. But it's very, very hard for them to actually be able to tell what is real and what is pretend. The question I ask is, can we really tell what is real? Now, this brings me to what I do. As the introduction said, I'm a filmmaker. But more importantly, I'm a storyteller. The stories that I and my ilk tell through the medium of cinema do exactly the same thing as any other story does. It unites or it divides people. Or, most often, it does both. Cinema takes an audience into a world that in all possibility they cannot otherwise imagine or experience. It shows them perspective that they might not otherwise have the chance to see. It put forth an argument and counter-arguments about any subject that I as a director or any other filmmaker chooses to discuss. Cinema is a medium for stories. And like I had said at the start, stories define who we are. So what really matters? It's a very difficult question to answer. Almost impossible, I'd say. Primarily, I would say that it's our ability to keep telling stories. Like I said before, if stories is our reality, if stories give us our individuality, if stories is what make us who we are, then I would say that our ability to tell stories is primarily the most important thing that we do. These stories will impact how people see the world, sometimes in small doses, sometimes in much larger doses, sometimes it has greater impact, sometimes much less. But as long as we believe we have free will, and the belief of free will, I'll have a discussion outside this room later with someone else, but not right now. Stories will do the job of giving us that perspective. We can go into a cinema and see what looks like an infinite amount of time that's been compressed into a few short hours. We believe that it's like a window. We're getting a peep into what can be. Does that mean as a filmmaker I have a responsibility to society? I think I do. I believe my responsibility is to be true to the thought with which I started the storytelling. To tell a story as honestly as possible so that once I put it out in the universe, the audience can then make up their own minds as to the questions and answers in that story. To be a human being is to have stories. I think I can safely say that everyone here and every human being on the face of this earth is made up of the stories they've either told or heard. We, professional storytellers, are celebrated. Why are we celebrated? Simply because we're the scribes who put those stories down. The stories that we choose to put down, the narrative that we choose to narrate, and the universe that we choose to create. Visual storytelling today is probably the most consumed style of storytelling. And so that gives filmmakers a lot of power. We have a responsibility, but what is that responsibility? I believe we only have one responsibility, and that is to keep telling stories. Noam Chomsky, the thinker, believes that human beings don't really make choice. No choice is of their own volition. Most often, our choices are those that someone else has made for us. Films and the stories, to me, is that someone else. They help people make choices. They build a collective conscience. It's a collective conscience that creates change. So it would be logical to surmise that films are a powerful tool to create change. So what is the relationship between cinema and society? And the change we want to see around us? Is cinema more influenced by society, or does cinema influence society more? I think the former. But having said that, cinema does define popular culture. What is popular culture? Popular culture is nothing but the amalgamation of things that at that point in time, art at that point in time, that defines who you are. To that extent, filmmakers have a responsibility. I believe there are two ways in which they have to be responsible. One is to be truthful to the reality that surrounds us and be a mirror to society, even in all its unacceptable behavior. By that, what I mean is, as an example, there is misogyny in the world. It exists. It is real, and therefore it should find its way into mainstream conversation. But as filmmakers, we have a choice. Do we want to celebrate misogyny, or do we not? Cinema is a manipulative medium. It's a story told from the perspective of one person, the director. Every line written, every shot taken, every scene constructed manipulates the audience to understand the perspective from which the director has chosen to approach that particular subject. Therefore, the resulting impact of the story can be very, very one-sided if it is not questioned. Secondly, change. Change doesn't just happen. Change is a slow process. It builds up one step at a time until it reaches that tipping point. And in order to help that transition, I believe cinema can play a very big part. Films incorporate little things, small ideas that questions the accepted, small changes that we would like to see in society. It makes it easier for people to accept new ideas and thoughts. They help build up towards that tipping point. As an example, I was shooting a film where the lead protagonist, female protagonist, there was a scene where she's having a drink with some friends of hers. So my art assistant, who's the guy who has to make sure the drinks are there, the glass is there, and the table is there, came to me with a list. And in this list, he said, sir, here are the drinks I'm going to have. And he said, there's whiskey and there's wine. And when I saw the list, all the men were drinking whiskey. All the women were drinking wine. And so I turned around to him and said, why aren't any men drinking wine? Why aren't the women drinking whiskey? And he kind of was flummoxed. He never asked himself this question. Because he accepted what was normal. He never thought about it. If we see more women drinking whiskey, it becomes the accepted normal. I'm not saying that everyone should be drinking whiskey, not for a moment. I'm just saying that the way you show these little things can be extrapolated to every little element of society. The clothes worn, the attitudes depicted, sexual behavior, pretty much every other stereotype that we come to accept. So that begets the question, what is stereotype? Stereotyping in cinema, I would define as the simplification of character and the ideas into good, bad, protagonist, antagonist, and the rest of it. Unfortunately, this is one of the biggest limiting factors that we have in cinema. But this is also what makes it so much easier to create a concrete idea of right and wrong. It's simple. Bad, good, evil, cool, playboy, hot, nerd. The simplistic approach of stereotyping makes it easier for an audience to digest these concepts. The influence of cinema is very real, but since oftentimes this does not reflect in their real lives, the lives that the audience really live, the influence is often limited. All these words and behaviors attached to them have a universality. To some extent, that's because of its depiction in popular art, especially cinema. Popular culture, if you defined it, is defined as a culture that's adhered to and accepted by a large number of generally youth. Now, this definition automatically means, what is it that makes these young people find one thing to follow? Generally cinema. Maybe some other art forms or music. So do films have, if you made a film about the problems that women face in, let's say, rural India, when they don't have a toilet, you see this film, does that lead to more toilets being built? Does it lead to some resolution for these women? Data suggests it doesn't. But what it does, it is changes behaviors and attitudes. It definitely makes people start a conversation. Most importantly, it makes people talk about things that they otherwise would not talk about. It removes stigmas. I made a film about 10 years ago called Barahana. In it, I had set out to understand how, despite this tremendous divide between the rich and the poor, and the poor being 95% of this country, I would say, in numbers, why is it that they don't resort to violence? Why is it that they don't come out and just take it all? Why is there no violent revolution in this country? And as I started speaking to people, I found out that the answer is that human beings want dignity. It is not about being rich or poor. It is not about money. It is not about power. It is about dignity. Much, much more powerful tool than poverty. So when the film came out, I started getting some reactions to the film. Some people were angry with me, but most people came out and said, I learned something. And when I heard that, I felt that I had achieved something. The film got some people to start thinking about how they were treating people around them. And because the idea was about dignity, and it was a definitive idea, it was easier for these people to start making those changes in their own lives. It was not about money, it was not about power, it was about dignity. Dignity is very, very, very easy to give to someone if you choose to do that. So when I started seeing that people were making these concrete steps to rectify some of the anger that the people around them, especially the people who worked for them, were feeling, that was the moment when I felt the real meaning of what I do. To me, that's what mattered, to be able to impact society and people in a real way. I was able to do that by showing them a perspective that they hadn't thought through. It wasn't that they didn't want to think about it. They never once actually went down that path. They never thought about it. Today, cinema is the most accessible form of art in India. And therefore, I would say the most influential. This gives the filmmaker a great amount of power. And like Uncle Ben in Spider-Man said, with great power comes great responsibility. Therefore, I would like to end this talk by saying what really matters to me as a filmmaker is that we continue to tell stories, but tell them with a sense of responsibility. Responsibility to a society we want to live in. Tell stories that impact the world around us and impact them positively. Thank you.